Hello, I'm Chris. I'm a product manager on the Edge DevTools team, and this is what's new in the Edge Developer Tools for version 109. This time we added a lot of new performance and memory investigation features that help you create more responsive sites. In 109, we added enhanced traces, a new way to share memory and performance recordings with other people that preserves a lot more data than previously possible. We also added selector stats to the performance tool. These help you to discover which CSS selectors may impact your site performance. The memory tool now makes it possible to track the objects that were garbage collected during a memory allocation recording. We published a new DevTools extension that lets you visualize your memory recordings like never before. We improved focus mode by redesigning the quick view pane to show several tools at once. And finally, we added new entries to the command menu for voice command users to navigate to the styles and computed styles panes. Let's dive in. First up, enhanced traces. It's already possible to export memory and performance recordings as files and share these with other people so they can help you investigate problems. However, when somebody else imports a file and they don't have exactly the same environment as you have, a lot of data will be missing. For example, going from the recording to the source code will be impossible. With Microsoft Edge 109, you can turn on a setting to export enhanced traces. Go to Settings, scroll down to the Persistence section, turn on the Export Enhanced Performance and Memory Traces option. An enhanced trace preserves console messages, DOM snapshots, and the JavaScript that's running on the page when you export the memory or performance trace. Now go to the Memory or Performance tool, take a recording, and export the recording by saving the DevTools file. When you import the enhanced trace, a new separate DevTools window opens up and recreates the state of your console, sources, and elements tools. It's a powerful new way to collaborate and share the information in your DevTools with others. We're actively experimenting with this feature, so if you have any feedback about it, please file an issue at aka.ms/devtools-issue. Next, selector stats. When part of your web page changes, for example because new DOM elements were added, the rendering engine of the browser needs to recalculate the styles that apply to the page. This means going over all the CSS rules and checking which ones apply where. If your page has a lot of elements, the way you write your CSS selectors may cause the browser to do more work and render more slowly. In Microsoft Edge 109, in the Performance tool, you can now turn on the Enable Advanced Rendering Instrumentation setting to learn how much time the browser took to recalculate your CSS selectors. Turn on the setting in the Performance tool, click Record, execute the scenario you want to improve on your web page, and click Stop. Now, if you find a long-running Recalculate Style event, click on it and go to the Selector Stats tab. This tab provides a list of all the CSS selectors that were calculated by the browser engine during the event. You can sort selectors by the time they took to process or the number of elements they matched. With this data, you can find the selectors that took the longest to process and change them to improve performance. Now, in the memory tool, we added new options for allocation sampling to track how much garbage your website is generating. When you record allocations, only the objects that weren't garbage collected during the recording are tracked. But with the new Include Objects Discarded by GC options, you can now preserve the garbage collected objects in the report. You will therefore be able to see how much garbage your website generates during the recording and then use this data to reduce it and improve performance. To learn more about the different types of garbage collection, check out this talk about Orinoco, the V8 garbage collector at v8.dev/blog/trashtalk. And we also released a new DevTools extension that visualizes memory data as a graph or a tree. When you record a heap snapshot from the memory tool, you can explore the memory retainers as a list in the tool. But you can also export the data as a file, and you can load the file into our new extension, which gives you new ways to explore the data. Install the extension by going to aka.ms/heap-snapshot-visualizer. Open DevTools and go to the new Heap Snapshot Visualizer tab. Choose your heap snapshot file and click Load. The extension now shows you data as a graph that shows the retainers chain from the GC root to each individual nodes. You can also click Tree to explore the data as a tree instead. Next, in focus mode, we redesigned the Quick View pane based on your feedback. Before 109, displaying a tool in Quick View was done by choosing from a list of predefined tools. You can now add tools to the Quick View by using the More Tools button and show several tools at the same time, like in the main toolbar. The state of your Quick View also persists across sessions. And finally, we improved the accessibility of DevTools for users of voice commands. we found an issue where users could not go to the styles and computed style panes. We now added two new commands to the command menu, show styles and show computed styles, to give everyone easier access to these panes. That's it for the new features of Microsoft Edge DevTools 109, but before wrapping up, here's a quick tip. When inspecting elements on the page using the Inspect tool, hovered elements get highlighted, and you get a tooltip that gives you information about that element. This can be useful to find out about colors and dimensions, but also to learn if it has enough contrast or is keyboard accessible. It can get annoying though when you inspect elements that are very close to another. You can hide the information tooltip by holding down the Control key. You still get the color highlights, showing the dimension, padding and margin. You can also hold the Control and Alt key at the same time to keep showing the highlight and tooltip of the last hovered element. This makes it easier to read the information without needing pinpoint mouse accuracy. We're now wondering though if you should also make it possible for you to copy this information by holding down the C key at the same time. Let us know if that's something you'd like to see. And that's it for today. If you have feedback, ideas, feature requests or bugs, join our community on GitHub at github.com/microsoft-edge/devtools. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at MSEdgeDev and like and subscribe to stay tuned for what's coming next in Microsoft Edge 110.